हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू नॉलेज गैलेक्सी टू रीडिस्कवर द बेसिक्स विथ मयंक तिवारी, ए प्रीमियर कोचिंग एंड ट्रेनिंग चैनल डेडिकेटेड टू मेटलर्जी स्टडीज एंड कंसल्टेंसी, एस्टैब्लिश्ड टू कैटर द नीड्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स डिग्री डिप्लोमा एंड एम आई आई एम मेटलर्जी कंपिटिटिव एंड रिक्रूटमेंट एग्जाम्स फॉर गेट सेल एंड वेरियस कंपनीज metallurgical industries and whosoever seeking knowledge and information about various subjects and topics of metallurgy, operational process optimization, productivity improvement analysis, concepts like 5S, total productive maintenance, TPM, quality circle, QC, root cause analysis, RCA, ISO systems, QMS, EMS and OSHAs, practical and effective communication English, written and spoken. In today's video, we will be discussing about ferroalloys overview. Let's start. Steel is the most versatile material which has made the progress in every aspect on this earth possible. There are hundreds of varieties of steel because for each application, it has to be made with specific properties to get the most optimum usage. It is well known that the basic constituent of steel is iron, but it is the proportion of other elements in which it gives, which gives each type of steel certain specific properties. Various elements are added to the steel in the form of their ferroalloys to increase their recovery and reduce the losses, heat energy and time required for their reactions with the liquid steel. Thus, ferroalloys are important additives in the production of steel. Steel cannot be made without the use of one or more of the many ferroalloys. In other words, it can be stated that ferroalloys are the backbone of steel. Thus, the ferroalloys industry is vitally linked for its growth and development to that of the steel industry. Ferroalloys introduction. Ferroalloys are the alloys of iron and the other metals in which the other metal is the base metal and is present in larger quantity than iron. Ferroalloys are used in steel making as deoxidizing agents and alloying additions. These are one of the important inputs in the manufacturing of alloy and special steel. Ferroalloys impart special properties to steel depending upon the element of the ferroalloy added. The function of the alloys is to deoxidize and impart special properties like increased corrosion resistance, resistance to oxidation, hardness, strength at high temperature, malleability, ductility, toughness, abrasion resistance, electrical conductivity and resistivity, thermal spalling resistance. Ferroalloys production is a thermochemical process. It is a reduction smelting process. The reduction smelting process can be an endothermic reaction process or an exothermic reaction process depending upon the reducing agent used. The reduction process can be either carbothermic or metallothermic. If carbon is used as a reducing agent, then the process is known as carbothermic. If aluminium or any other metal is used as a reducing agent, then the process is known as metallothermic. The carbothermic reduction process is endothermic in nature. The metallothermic reduction process is exothermic in nature. For carbothermic reduction smelting processes, they are needed a submerged electric arc furnace in which carbonaceous materials are used as reducing agent only, and main source of energy is electrical energy. It is supplied from the transformer through copper bus bar, copper flexible cables, copper tubes, terminal boards and contact pads to the carbon electrodes encased in steel casing. This is an schematic representation of submerged electric arc furnace used for the production of various ferroalloys. The power generated at power plant, is wheeled through 132 by 66 by 32 by 11 kV substations to the transformers, and from these transformers it goes to the bus bars, and from there to the flexible cables and connected to the bus tubes, and finally to the electrode holding assembly, and via contact pads it goes to the carbon electrodes. The carbon electrodes are submerged in the charged materials which present the required resistance to the flow of the electric current, thereby creating the arc, generating the arc inside the charged materials, and this generates the required amount of heat, and for the continuation and starting and continuation of the chemical reactions. The liquid metal and slag are collected at the bottom of the furnace electrodes, and then they are tapped from tap holes time to time based on the electrical energy consumption. This is the other furnace details as can be seen. Carbon electrodes can be of two types. First, self-baking Söderberg type, and second, pre-baked graphite electrode type. Heavy amperes and low voltage is applied to get the required electrical resistance inside the furnace charge materials, which converts the electrical energy into thermal heat at the reaction zone, which is required to start and continue the chemical reactions. Various types of ferroalloys: ferromanganese, ferrosilicon, ferrochrome, silicomanganese, ferrotitanium, ferrovanadium, ferrotungsten, ferromolybdenum, ferronickel, ferroboron, and ferroniobium. These are the main types of ferroalloys. Along with this, the upper four are called as common ferroalloys, and the rest are called noble ferroalloys. Manganese alloys are mostly used in steel making and foundry activities. Some 30% of the manganese used today in steel making is still used for its properties as a deoxidant and a sulfide former. In this last case, it combines with sulfur, avoiding the formation of iron sulfides, which are low melting point phases which become liquid at hot rolling temperatures and which consequently generate surface cracking. The other 70% of the manganese is used purely as an alloying element. Steels usually contain from 0.2 to 2% manganese depending on the grades, as manganese is the cheapest alloying element among those which enhance some key mechanical properties like strength and toughness. In the specific case of stainless steel, it can substitute expensive nickel in some austenitic grades called 200 series. There are two families of manganese alloys called ferromanganese FeMn and silicomanganese SiMn. Silicomanganese adds additional silicon, which is a stronger deoxidant. Nitrogen, boron, titanium, phosphorus are elements which can be controlled depending on the requested specification. A very specific application of refined manganese alloys is a constituent in the coating of welding electrodes. Ferromanganese is a ferroalloy that has high content of manganese. It is manufactured by heating mixture of oxides Fe2O3 and MnO2 along with carbon, which is usually coke and coal, in an electric arc furnace or blast furnace. In the furnace, the oxides go through carbothermal reduction, hence producing ferromanganese, which is used as deoxidizer for steel. The major producers of ferromanganese are found in South Africa, Mexico, France, and Australia, among others. One of the major drivers of ferromanganese market is the growing demand of steel across the globe. Moreover, increasing demand from the aluminium in alloy sectors is also expected to fuel the growth of ferromanganese market. Ferromanganese has proved to be essential to steel and iron production owing to their oxidizing, sulfur fixing and alloying properties that has applications in chemical industry and steel industry among the others. The major consumption of ferromanganese is reported from the steel making segment. It also has applications in aluminium alloys and is used in dry cell batteries in the form of oxides. Ferromanganese is segmented into two types, namely high carbon ferromanganese and medium carbon ferromanganese. The primary features of this element include good antioxidant properties, excellent chemical composition and low melting point. High carbon ferromanganese is an excellent antioxidant with high carbon content and is heat resistant. Ferroalloys industry at present in India. In India, the industry's present capacity is around 5.15 million tons per annum. The products covered are manganese alloys, high carbon, medium carbon and low carbon ferromanganese and silicomanganese, ferrosilicon, chrome alloys, high carbon, medium carbon and low carbon ferrochrome, silicochrome and charge chrome. Noble ferroalloys, ferromolybdenum, ferromanadium, ferrotungsten, ferrosilicon, magnesium, ferroboron, ferrotitanium, etc. Thus, the ferroalloys industry, considered to be a vital industry, needs to be encouraged. It is envisaged by our planners that the industry should produce larger quantities of basic alloys, which are required for the growth of the steel industry at home and also to cater the international market. Transformer capacity wise was around 600 MVA prior to liberalization. Approximate capacity addition till date is 2300 MVA. At present, the total capacity has crossed 2900 MVA with a total output of 5.15 million tons approximately. The industry structure by capacity present represents as follows. Products manganese alloys capacity is around 3.16 million tons per annum, chromium alloys 1.69 million tons per annum, ferrosilicon 0.25, noble alloys 0.05, so total comes to 5.15 million tons per annum. Ferroalloys producers in India normally manganese base 63, chrome base 26, ferrosilicon 29. Overall capacity utilization is approximately 80%. Product range, manganese alloys 50%, chrome alloys 35%, ferrosilicon 9% and noble ferroalloys 6%. India ranks first in the world for export of silicomanganese and ranks fourth in the world for the export of ferromanganese. India is established as a regular exporter of silicomanganese and high carbon ferrochrome, with major exports into countries like Bangladesh, Europe, Germany, Indonesia, Japan, Korea, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, UAE, USA, etc. Industry has highly qualified manpower, latest equipments and technologies which have given recognition and position in the international market. Quality-wise rated one of the best in the world. Electricity cost accounts over 40 to 70% of the total cost of production depending on the ferroalloys produced. We need power at generation cost plus reasonable wheeling charges so that it can increase its exports and earn substantial foreign exchange for the country. Need a level playing field by supplying power at international comparable tariffs, that is at US$1 to $3 per kWh. Demand drivers of ferroalloys. Steel production, that is crude steel and alloy steels. Unit consumption trend. India is poised to grow in the ferroalloys production in line with the increased crude steel production. Chinese ferroalloy producers to focus on the needs of domestic demand. Export potential for Indian ferroalloys producers is very much. However, Indian ferroalloys business has to overcome few challenges to grab those opportunities. Indian ferroalloy industry, the challenges. First is the high power cost. High and rising reductants cost coupled with the low availability of reductants. Next is high freight cost on account of low priority for the raw materials requirement of ferroalloys by railways. Low economies of scale. Next is no import duty, CVD and sales tax for ferroalloys imports from neighboring countries like Nepal and Bhutan. Ferroalloys industry in India has never been globally competitive despite its rich ore deposits and low cost manpower, essentially due to first, insufficient availability of high cost of electric power, increasing ores and reductants cost. Third, non-availability of low ash, low phos coking coal in the country for the production of desired coke with low ash, low phos contents, making imports of such coke at a high cost imperative. High cost and insufficient infrastructural facilities, both road and rail, for rapid transportation of ores from mines to plants. Stiff competition from producers and exporters of ferroalloys in other countries like South Africa, Kazakhstan, China, Russia, Australia, etc. due to global trade agreement, which has made drastic reduction in customs duty on imports necessary. Wide fluctuations in the international price of ferroalloys depending on demand versus supply. Indian ferroalloys industry, the challenges. First, high power cost. Power tariffs in India is 3 to 5 times higher than that in the competing countries. Hence, globally, ferroalloys production is situated geographically in cheaper power locations. This table shows the power specific power consumption kWh per metric ton for some products. Like ferrosilicon, it requires 8000 kWh per metric ton, which accounts for 65% of total cost. Silicomanganese, it requires 4000 kWh per metric ton and accounts for 50% of total cost. Ferromanganese, 2900 kWh per metric ton, accounts for 45% of total cost. Ferrochrome, 3800 kWh per metric ton, accounts for 45% of total cost. Power tariff, India versus other countries. This table shows the power tariff comparison in India and other countries, which is very much self-explanatory. India is having 3 to 7 rupees per kWh, but the cheapest power is available at Norway, which is around 0.85 rupees per kWh, and Canada, which is 0.63 rupees per kWh. Other countries' power tariffs is shown in the table. High power cost. Though generation cost is not so high in India, tariff borne by the industry is very high because of cross-subsidization of agriculture sector, low plant load factor, and sizable transmission and distribution losses. Electricity duty, which varies widely from state to state, also creates additional burden for ferroalloys industry. Though power reforms are on with the introduction of Electricity Act 2003 in India, the impact of this development on long-term prices generally and specifically for intensive power consumption consumers such as ferroalloys producers is difficult to assess, since the electricity market still seems to be in a state of flux. Raw materials listing manganese ore, chrome ore, quartz, fluxes are available in India. However, Indian manganese ore is predominantly low grade, equivalent to 45%. This is the distribution of manganese ore present in India. Reductants. Coke is most widely used reductant in ferroalloys in production. Ferroalloys consume roughly around 0.6 to 0.7 tons of reductant per ton of production. Coal and coke of Indian origin suffers from high ash and volatile matter content. Due to non-availability of low-ash, low-phos metallurgical coke, Indian ferroalloy industry depends on imports. Stricter environmental controls in many countries have also put merchant coke batteries under long-term threat of closure. Increased demand for coke in China and curtailment of coke exports, high and rising coke costs globally. Reductants. Locally available reductants following the same price trends affecting the input costs of ferroalloys. Indian ferroalloy industry is further burdened by high level of import duty on coke, second anti-dumping duty on low-phos met coke. Logistics cost. The industry produces around 5.15 million tons of ferroalloys annually. Nearly 2.5 to 3 tons of such raw materials have to be moved by railway wagons for 1 ton of ferroalloy. The industry has been experiencing shortage of wagons for procuring raw materials. Freight element is very high, thus reducing the competitiveness of the industry. Poor infrastructure facilities at port also leading to berthing delays for ships and longer loading and unloading. How to overcome the challenges? First, power cost. Power to be made available at internationally comparable tariffs to give a level playing field to Indian ferroalloy industry with international players. The power tariff should be of long-term agreement. Cross subsidies to other industries must be removed and ferroalloy industry should be treated separately and a separate tariff should be fixed. Raw materials. To increase exploration efforts for evaluation of mineral reserves, to step up research and development activities to develop techno-commercially feasible techniques of low-grade ore beneficiation, by waiving customs duty, additional duty on ores used in production of noble ferroalloys, by reducing customs duty on coke, by removing anti-dumping duty on low-ash, low-phos metallurgical imports. Indian ferroalloy industry, the way ahead. Further, ferroalloy industry should be given special status and priority should be accorded for raw material movement. To reduce the rail freight on movement of raw materials for ferroalloys by classifying them as low freight category. To impose countervailing duty on ferroalloys imported from neighboring countries like Bhutan, Nepal, etc. Hope you liked the content and found the video worth. So please don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. Also remember to press the bell icon so that you can get the notification of the new videos promptly. Thank you.